What is up, Pokemon fans? Professor Prometheus Pine here, and welcome to Basics 1040, Introduction to Volatile Status Conditions. Alright, now there are no prerequisites for this course, so let's jump right in. First up is Confusion. Now, the Confusion condition causes a Pokemon to sometimes hurt itself in its Confusion instead of executing a selected move. From Gen 1 to 6, the chance to hurt itself is 50%, while changes in Gen 7 made it so that it is only a third of the time likely to hit itself in Confusion. Now, the damage is done as if the Pokemon attacked itself with a 40 power typeless attack that is physical. So, if you were to increase said Pokemon's attack, say it used Swords Dance, it would deal more damage to itself. It would also work lowering that Pokemon's defense. Now, Confusion wears off after 1 to 4 attacking turns. This means that turns recharging, such as after Hyper Beam, and turns that it is unable to attack, such as from Paralysis, will not lower the remaining number of turns of Confusion. However, a sleeping Pokemon may hurt itself in Confusion if using a move such as Snore or Sleep Talk. Multi-turn attacks, such as Fly and Dive, require Confusion to be checked both turns, further reducing the chances of a successful attack. Now, Pokemon with the Own Tempo ability are immune to being confused. Confusion itself can be cured with the Person Berries, Tauga Berries, the Yellow Flute, and from Gen 2 onwards, any item that cures all status conditions, such as Full Heals and Lum Berries. It is the only volatile status condition that can be cured with these such items. Now, Confusion is also transferable via Baton Pass. Next up is Curse. If a Ghost-type Pokemon uses the move Curse, the Pokemon it is used on loses a quarter of its maximum hit points every turn, and the user immediately loses half of their maximum hit points in exchange. A Pokemon afflicted by Curse cannot be healed except by switching out. If the victim of a Ghost-type Pokemon's Curse uses Baton Pass, the health sapping effect is transferred to its replacement. Also in Gen 2, defeating the opponent will prevent the Pokemon it is used on taking damage from Curse on that turn. Encore forces the Pokemon to repeat its last attack for 2 to 5 turns in Generation 2, 4 to 8 turns in Generations 3 and 4, and 3 turns in Generation 5 onward. In Generation 5, if the Pokemon has Magic Coat active, the move will fail. Flinch. Now, the Flinch status is a one-turn status that prevents a Pokemon from attacking. A Pokemon can only flinch if its opponent attacks first. A Pokemon who is holding a King's Rock or Razor Fang has a 10% chance of causing a target to flinch when using certain moves. In Gen 2 and 3, any move that deals damage but does not have a secondary effect. In Gen 4, one of several moves on a list of exclusive to those two items. In Gen 5 onward, any move that deals damage and does not already have a chance to flinch. Now, Pokemon with the Inner Focus ability are also immune to this. Most moves that cause flinching are physical moves, and Pokemon with Steadfast still flinch but gain speed each time they do so. Onward to Heal Block. A Pokemon affected by Heal Block is prevented from healing for 5 turns. It cannot use Moonlight, Morning Sun, Roost, Recover, etc. And it is unaffected by the healing effects of Wish, Ingrain, Aqua Ring, Leech Seed, and Heal Pulse. In Generation 4 and 5, a Pokemon affected by Heal Block can use HP draining moves and still inflict damage, but will not restore HP. In Generation 6, a Pokemon affected by Heal Block cannot use HP draining moves except for Leech Seed. Now, the Pokemon with the ability such as Volt Absorb or Water Absorb will take damage as opposed to healing from those respective types while Heal Block is in effect. A Poison Pokemon with Poison Heal is neither healed nor damaged. From Generation 5 onwards, Leftovers and Shell Bell cannot heal Pokemon affected by Heal Block, and in Generation 6, Black Sludge is added to this list as well. Items such as Potions can still be used, however, to heal the Pokemon. Now, onward to Identification. The opponent's Evasion modification will not affect the accuracy of a Pokemon that is used Foresight, Odor Sleuth, or Miracle Eye. In addition, a normal or fighting type move used by a Pokemon that has used Foresight or Odor Sleuth will affect a ghost type Pokemon, and psychic type moves used by a Pokemon that has used Miracle Eye will affect dark type Pokemon. Infatuation. A Pokemon that is infatuated cannot attack 50% of the time, even against a Pokemon other than the one that it is currently infatuated with. It is caused when Attract is used on an opponent of the opposite gender. It may be caused when a Pokemon makes contact with a Pokemon of the opposite gender that has the Cute Charm ability, and is caused to the target of the infatuation when a Pokemon holding a Destiny Knot has been infatuated. Now, Pokemon with the Oblivious ability are immune to the infatuation, and infatuation cannot be passed via Baton Pass. Infatuation will end as soon as either the Pokemon is attracted to is removed from the battle. So, say you had your Growlithe going up against the Blissey. Your Growlithe is a male, the Blissey is a female. You hit it with something like Bite. The ability, Cute Charm, will cause it to be infatuated, and your Growlithe, the only way that this can be removed is if the Blissey is called back, the Blissey faints, or your Growlithe's called back, or the Growlithe faints. Now, it can also be removed by consuming a Mental Herb, or an Agant Berry, or by playing a Red Flute. Now, for Leech Seed. The Leech Seed status can only be caused by the move Leech Seed. Each turn, a Pokemon afflicted with Leech Seed loses 1/8, 1/16 of Gen 1 of its maximum hit points. When the opponent is healed by the same amount, Grass-type Pokemon cannot be afflicted with Leech Seed. If a Pokemon afflicted with Leech Seed uses Baton Pass, it is transferred to its replacement, regardless of type. If the Pokemon that uses Leech Seed switches out or faints, any Pokemon in the same position as the original user gains the drained HP instead. Now on to Nightmare. Nightmare only affects a sleeping Pokemon. The sleeping Pokemon will lose 1/4 of its maximum hit points every turn. So you could look at it as an equivalent to the move Curse. They both will inflict 1/4 of the opponent's hit points every turn, whereas Nightmare only does it during when they're asleep, and Curse, you lose half your own life. Now, if the sleeping Pokemon awakens, then the Nightmare will no longer be in effect. If Baton Pass switches in a Pokemon that is not asleep via the move Sleep Talk, then the Nightmare will no longer be in effect. So, if it switches to another Pokemon that is asleep, Nightmare will be in effect. Now on to Partially Trapped. When a Pokemon is hit by a binding move, or partially trapping move, such as Magma Storm, Sand Tomb, Whirlpool, Wrap, Bind, etc., it becomes Bound. Prior to Gen 5, this lasts 2 to 5 turns. 5 turns if the user has binding, or the user of the binding move held a Grip Claw. From Generation 5 onward, the Bound status lasts 4 to 5 turns, with the Grip Claw making it 7 turns. A Pokemon can only be bound by one binding move at a time. So the effects of Fire Spin and, say, Whirlpool cannot stack. Now, if a binding band is held by the user of the binding move, the damage done at the end of each turn will increase from 1/16 to 1/8. In Generation 6, that increases from the now dealing 1/8 to the 1/6. Furthermore, Ghost-type Pokemon are also immune to the trapping effects of these moves in Generation 6 onward. Perish Song. Now, after 3 turns, all Pokemon who heard the Perish Song, it's a move, will faint, excluding Pokemon with the soundproof ability. Any Pokemon who heard it can avoid the effect of fainting if it is switched out before the 3-turn count finishes. Baton Pass does transfer a Perish Song count down. Now on to Taunt. A taunted Pokemon cannot use any status moves for 3 turns, 2 to 4 turns prior to Gen 5, including status moves that will always turn into damaging moves, like Nature Power. The Taunt status can only be inflicted by the move Taunt. From Generation 5 onward, the Mental Herb cures the Pokemon of Taunt. From Gen 6 onward, Pokemon with Oblivious are immune to Taunt, and if a Pokemon with Oblivious is affected by Taunt, such as if it is taunted by a Pokemon with the ability like Mold Breaker, it will be cured immediately. Pokemon with Aroma Veil and their allies are also immune to Taunt. On to Telekinetic Levitation. A Pokemon that is telekinetically levitated by Telekinesis is immune to Ground-type moves, Spikes, Toxic Spikes, and Arena Trap for 3 turns. In addition, all other moves except one-hit knockout moves hit the target regardless of accuracy and evasion. However, it does not allow moves to hit semi-invulnerable Pokemon, such as those that are in the air during Fly or under the ground during Dig. The effect of Telekinesis is cancelled when Gravity is used, the telekinetic Pokemon uses Ingrain, or the levitated Pokemon obtains an Iron Ball. Telekinesis cannot lift targets if Gravity is in effect, and will fail if a target that is rooted or holding an Iron Ball. And on to Torment. A tormented Pokemon cannot use the same move twice in a row. If the Pokemon is holding a choice item or only has one move remaining with power points, it is forced to use Struggle every second turn. Alright, and that's going to be the end for this episode. I hope you guys liked what you saw. Hope you guys learned a lot. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to leave a like on the video. Leave comments if you have questions. And subscribe to the channel if you want to see more content such as this or any of my walkthroughs. Alright, that is all. Professor Prometheus Pine, out.